Well, in Nashville, you might not think about Vietnamese as being local cuisine. This would probably fall in the category of off the beaten path, but probably the best value for food in Nashville. The food here is excellent, and it's really hard to spend about 10 bucks per person here. It's really, really good food. You're going to enjoy this. We're going to start off with the Vietnamese pancakes. They're a little more complicated than they look. First time we came, they laughed at us because we didn't know how to eat them. But what we do here is you take a slice, kind of cut that off, and they give you lettuce and mint. You take the mint, or excuse me, the lettuce, put that in there like that, a little bit of mint. And it comes with this, it's kind of a sweet kind of vegetable vinaigrette. And then I add my favorite spice, sriracha, which is kind of like a Asian Tabasco sauce. You kind of fold all that up, almost like a taco, and you eat it. And it's really good, a really good texture of the fresh lettuce and the crispy crunchiness of the pancake. It's really outstanding. Well, for our entree, we have bun. You can get it in different kinds. Mrs. Ned has chosen shrimp only, has grilled shrimp on top of it. And mine has, as you can see here, egg rolls and barbecued pork. Bun is it's kind of a meal in itself. There's underneath it is it's a salad. And then as you can see, there's pasta in here. And then the pork and the egg rolls. What we do is pour this vinaigrette on it, like that. And of course, as always, I'm gonna add a little sriracha. It's really a tasty treat here. Very good, very good. We're here at Jay Alexander's. This is another restaurant we're looking at this week. And normally we wouldn't be looking at a chain restaurant, but the chain actually is based here in Nashville. It's really good. One great thing about it is, as you can see, we're right here in the shadow of the football stadium. So it's really a good place. You can come early before the game, park your car, go to the game, maybe come back and have dinner after the game. So I think you'll enjoy it a lot here. Here's our favorite waitress, Amanda, here at City House. Amanda, tell us about City House. What's it about?
Well, City House is about what would an Italian chef do with Southern ingredients? So if you're given all these awesome Southern ingredients, what would an Italian chef do with that? It's family-oriented. You know, we're all one big family here. We love our regular customers, like these guys. And it's just about really promoting local food and, you know, Southern values, all that good stuff.
Well, and hog fans would probably be happy. It's all about the pig here.
It's all about the pig.
It's all about the pig.
We get a whole pig all the time. They butcher it in-house. We use the entire animal. We make our own house-made salami, sausages, and things like that. like that. So if you like pig, come to City House.
Give us a pig soup. Well, when we're here at City House, we like sometimes to sit at the bar. We can sit right in front of the wood-burning oven. We've ordered tonight to start off with a pizza margarita. Pizza in here at City House, it's the best pizza in Nashville, bar none. It's a Neapolitan-style pizza. They make everything here in-house. You cook it on the wood-burning oven. It's really good. We'll get a little piece here. So what we've got tonight is a large dish of linguine with mussels, and we've got some roast chicken also. The roast chicken is really about as good a roast chicken as I've ever had. They cook it on the hardwood oven over there, and it's really tasty. We'll tuck into that in a minute. We're on the entree now. We have the roast chicken, and that's really good. Well, it's Sunday, and it should come as no surprise that we're here again at King Yang. You can find us here just about any Sunday. What might come as a surprise for you, though, is the best barbecue sandwich in Nashville is actually at King Yang. This is barbecue pork with cilantro and pickled vegetables. And I'm telling you, it is just fantastic. It's on French bread, and it costs about $3. It's a really great deal, too. I forgot the sriracha, the critical part. I'm telling you, this is a great sandwich. You gotta try it.
Head out Highway 100, you can get up to the Bistro 360. A really fine dining here. It's a really nice restaurant. It's really the hot new chefs in Nashville. I think you're gonna really like this one a lot.
Well, we're here in our favorite neighborhood restaurant, 360 Bistro, and here's our waiter, Will. Will, tell us what's this restaurant about?
It's meant about going local farm, local growers, trying to find local produce, local, like, self-sustainable farms and stuff, and going mainly from farm to restaurant.
Yeah.
So it's finding whatever we can do locally and making good, fresh products.
Yeah, well, it's really a great place. We really love coming here, and it's right in our hood, so it's convenient for us. A little off the beaten path from downtown to work the trip out. So here's Will with our first course. What is that, Will?
This is a tricolored corn puree topped off a little bit of a chili oil, just a little dash of some breadcrumbs.
All right, looks good.
All right. And with a wax apple and whole grain mustard remoulade. And here we have caramelized onion with Gruyere cheese French baguette with our French fries that everyone seems to love so much.
Yeah, that looks great. Thanks.
All right. Enjoy.
New chef David Miller, can you tell us a little bit about what your vision is for the restaurant?
Sure. 360 Bistro for me is going to be contemporary American with a bistro flair. Should be exciting, fresh, farm-to-table food.
Excellent.
That's the plan.
Well, we've come towards the end of our restaurant tour here in Nashville. We're at the 12 South area. That's a new area that's been recently developed. A lot of nice places here. It's very close to Belmont University. It's pretty conveniently located. We have behind us here Burger Up. It's a really good place to get a burger. They have other things too. It's very good. I would recommend that also. But we're going to head down the street here to another place in just a minute. Well, we made it down to Fish and Company, arguably the best seafood place in town. They have an award-winning chef, Chef Louis Osteen.
who has been nominated for a James Beard Award. They have really good seafood here. They have a raw bar, fantastic oysters, a lot of fried seafood, but also grilled seafood too. It's Sunday, they have a Sunday brunch. We're gonna check it out for the Sunday brunch.
Oh, here at Fishing Company, we focus on the freshness of ingredients. We try and purchase locally as much as we can. A couple staples that we have, the sheet crab soup and the shrimp and grits, our chef is well known for. He won a James Beard Award for that. And just, you know, we're known for providing exceptional low country coastal cuisine.
Well, our food's arrived. I've opted for the shrimp basket, which I'm telling you, this is as good a fried shrimp as you can get. It's really crispy. They fry it in peanut oil. Crunchy, light, delicate, really good. Mrs. Ned is opting for the breakfast sandwich with Benton's bacon, which is the best bacon in the world. Should be a really good meal. Thanks for watching. Well, that was really tasty. I think hog fans will be well served here. I might even want to look into the hangover burger, which looked pretty good with a fried egg on top of it. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you all make it to Nashville, and we welcome you to our home. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Just push that button right up there, and we'd be happy to have you subscribe.